the children back to the father and the heart of the father back to the children. So what is our motherland? Africa. What is our fatherland? Africa. So we are the children from Africa. We come from Mother Africa. Biologically, we come from. We come from the hottest part of Africa, which is called Uganda, which today is called Uganda, which is today called Equatorial Africa. That's where we come from. Now, there has been a prophecy that's written in Genesis. Genesis chapter 5, chapter 15, verses 12 through 16. We talk about a people being enslaved, taken to a strange land that is not their own. And that land that the Most High or the ancestors will judge. Now you gotta remember, you gotta start personalizing when you see the word God. I taught you what the word God means. I told you the word God is a plural word. The word God comes from three Greek words, gomer, os, and bar, which means wisdom, self, and beauty, which are physical attributes. And it means a group of beings. So if you understand that the original gods of the planet were black, then you understand who you're talking about. So our ancestors will judge this land after our suffering. Because it tells you who the people were. You have to understand the biblical name. I ask people today, do you know what the Chinese mentioned in the Bible? Most people don't know. When you look at the Chinese, they're referred to as the Edomite. When you refer to the Europeans, they refer to many different names. One of them being the Amorite. This particular prophecy that I'm talking about is the Amorite. Amorite means mountain dweller. At one time, they were known as the cursed seed of Canaan. Why were they cursed? They were cursed for leprosy. Leprosy is a curse. Now, a lot of people don't even ask you where the Orientals come from, but they also come from a curse. They come from the curse of Down syndrome called Mongolism today. When you see an Oriental today, he's what you call...
A degenerative black man.
Excuse me? A degenerative black man. That too, but what I want to say is that he is more so... Because Down syndrome, most people think of Down syndrome is a form of retardation. When you see a so-called healthy Oriental, he's mildly retarded, meaning that your Orientals have no eyelids, that's why they have an eye shape. Matter of fact, what gives them the mongoloid look is that they have 47 chromosomes due to our own regular 46, and that comes from admixture through other beings that some people call extraterrestrials, some people call God. Because there's a lot of things that happen on this planet that Europeans are making money on because it's not being forthcoming, such as you hear programs about Bigfoot, which are nothing but the Shaggy. All the cultures talk about these different beings. And they have found, if you get a book called Forbidden Archaeology, you'll see where they have found all different types of strange remains of giants and things that the Bible talks about, the Nephilim, those who came down. You find a lot of those things, but they do not let that be known because they don't want you to know that there's a power greater on the earth greater than the white man. So you have to come understand that it's a lot of things that they don't tell you that is known and that's a fact. So you have to expand your horizon, understand that in order to get an accurate knowledge of the truth, you have to do your own research. Research means R-E-P to do again, to search it out. You have to look for the truth. And you cannot destroy truth. You can hide it, but you cannot destroy it. And you have a lot of black people today that ask the question and say, why is all this coming out now? Because the devil was given 6,000 years to rule. That's why in 2 Thessalonians, it's chapter 2, and 3 and 9, they talk about there has to be a falling away first before the truth is revealed. So that falling away was that period of spiritual ignorance of 6,000 years. Now the nation of Islam talks about the devil ruling for 6,000 years. What that means is that that was a degenerative period of 6,000 years where the amber light that comes from the star complex is why astrology is so important, that disempower you and empower them. Now you got to remember 6,000 years ago, the Europeans were in the cave of the Caucasus Mountains. They were cavemen. This is why they made cartoons like the Flintstones, how they used to be. Then they made another cartoon of the Jetsons, how they want to be. So you got to understand that they let you know where they come from and where they're going. Now, I always ask people, now you look at the state of the world today. Now, what's the number one thing that Europeans spend their money on today besides defense? Anybody know?
Technology.
Right, so technology go out there, out space. So if your house is burning down and you spend more money on transportation, that means you're trying to get the hell out of here. They got option one, option two, option three. Now they made movies like such as Close Encounter of the Third Kind. See, they're just not making this up. They understood what the first encounter was. The first encounter was mentioned in Genesis. Genesis 6:4, when he talks about the masters coming down. Those sons of God see the daughters of men were beautiful and came down and had sex with them. That's the first encounter. The second encounter was when Jesus came down. Jesus said, I'm not from this world, I'm from above. right there from the same. I'm not from this world. He said, I'm from above. You're from below. Third encounter is when the masters come back. It's spoken of in Revelation when you talk about Ezekiel's wheel, the mother plane. The most honorable Elijah Muhammad made that more popular among us when you talk about the mother plane. But he's not the first to talk about that. Matter of fact, I can show you a science magazine in 1950 that they were aware of the mother plane. Matter of fact, if you do some research and you look at the Russians, they're being more forthcoming because three nations in the world today that are not opening to the public about their UFO files, which we call ours over there have been identified. Because, see, we have this arrogance of thinking that we're the only ones in the universe, that we're the only life, and that's not true. Even to your Bible, like if I was talking to a room full of Hindus and I said that the gods came down from this galaxy, then I would be right on point because in their culture, that's what they understand. Because for years I studied a form of Hinduism called Siddha Yoga, and they talk about that Krishna and the Bhagavad Gita, the Upanishads, the Vedas and the Vedic tradition. They talk about things that open. They talk about flying machines. They talk about lasers. They call Vedamas, which are flying machines. In Islam, they call Merkaba, which means movable throne. In Ezekiel, it talks about the same thing. It said a mile by half mile, talking about a little ship. When you look at the movie Independence Day, that's a more portrayal or accurate of what World War III is supposed to be about. The Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad taught us that he said that it will be a war in the sky. The Bible is talking about the end time, there will be a war in the sky. When you look at John the Revelator, he's explaining a lot of different things. He talked about a star falling to the ground and stuff. And he's describing things from his time point of view where he's trying to explain. He's explaining nuclear war. He's talking about nuclear physics. He's talking about a lot of different things that he articulate in his language, but when you understand the language and the words that they use, you understand what they're really talking about. So you have to understand that now the time that we're living in is that time right now. We're living the time. The scriptures are being fulfilled today. The Quran is being fulfilled today. The Bible is being fulfilled today. Like I said, you shouldn't look at Old Testament, New Testament, Quran. You should look at First Testament, Second Testament, Third Testament, because they go hand in hand. If you do not have this understanding, then you'll be lost because you don't understand what time is. Because the Quran picks up where the Bible left off. Just like I told people, Jesus had a book. His book was called the Injil, which we call today Revelation. You find that in chapter 1, verse 1, it tells you this is a revelation that is given to Jesus, certified by him unto his servant John. These are the things that will shortly come to pass. This talks about that. It talks about that in Revelation. Revelation is talking about today. Daniel corresponds to Revelation. This is why in Daniel chapter 12, verse 4, it talks about there will be an increase in knowledge of people going to and fro. The to and fro means people will be in confusion. When a person goes to and fro, back and forth, that represents confusion. But there will be an increase in knowledge. That's why the Europeans did not off when he said this is the information age. This is why this knowledge is coming back. There's an African proverb that said knowledge crushed to the ground will come again. You throw a black man to the ground, he will rise again. Truth is coming back. Truth is rising. You got to understand, their demise is our rise. Our demise is their rise. So for 6,000 years, you have been put to sleep, meaning that they could not rule if you was awake. They could not do it. So they had to put you to sleep by depriving you of the knowledge itself. Now, if you look at the first major European civilization, it was Greece. But when you look at Greece and you know the history of the Minoan people who were a colony of the Egyptians, they were the ones who gave civilization to the Greeks because they was King Amasis who built temples and there to foster learning to civilize Europeans. Why did we civilize the Europeans? So we can do trading and so we can deal with it. You can't have a beast running around here and be totally uncivilized. So we made attempts to civilize it, but according to the legends of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, the devil cannot be civilized. So why try? The reason being that they had to come about through the gravitational period because through our hard-headedness and mixture with other beings, because this is why the Bible said, have no other God before me. We went after other strange gods and we mixed in with other strange beings, and we had to get that genetic default out of our genetic makeup. That was the whole purpose of the gravitation. Now, I'm talking about genetic science, and some of you can relate to it today because this is what the Europeans are doing today. I told you, genetic science is nothing new. It's nothing new. This is just an old science. The Sumerians, the Egyptians, and all people have practiced some form of genetic science or genetic manipulation. When you understand how the principles of the universe work, when you work with universal law, you understand. See, science and magic is one and the same in ancient times because the magi were scientists. They understood the principles of the universe. This is why yoga is a technology. Yoga is not just some exercise that you do. Yoga is something that's how you can harmonize your spirit with the spiritual energies of the universe, how you're able to manifest certain innate abilities in you. When you look at manifestation, that means to bring it into the physical. But the word man comes from the Sanskrit word manas, which means mind. So when you say manifestation, you talk about mind manifestation. If you want to invent this table, you see it in your mind and you bring it forth. That's power. That's the power of the man. That's what God has. Because a lot of people say, well, if you're talking about God, why are you talking about spaceships and stuff like that? Because God don't need that. Yes, the all doesn't need that, but we're talking about other beings who are human-like, some are, some are not, that have advanced technology that will appear to be as alien to us because we're so behind, because we have been behind, because the white man had kept us in a spiritual and technological drug. Here's the people who just over a little 400 years ago thought the world was flat. And today, they're not even telling you about the real rotation of the earth. Now, when you was in school, when I was in school, they said the sun sat there and we went around there and all the bodies, they had the little Sir Isaac Newton display how the universe worked. And that's not even true. From the Moorish perspective, the sun is constantly moving and we spiral around it. Everything spirals. Your hair spirals. The universe spirals. You look at snowflakes, spiral. That is the pattern of the universe. Damn. Everything's in constant movement. Nothing's at rest. That's a universal principle, flat out, point blank. You have to understand the time that we live in. And so a lot of people say, well, you know they're changing the calendar because according to Daniel 7:25, there were people become to change the calendar because, like I said before, September the 9th month of Seth in Greek means seven. You know, I mean it's a 10 month, but it means eight. But see, they didn't change it. Novi is 11 month or November, and it really means nine. Death means 10. So you have to understand that they, even though they did what they did, we have to do what we do. We have to get back in harmony with our true spirituality, cosmology. The word cosmology means universe, the study of universal order. That's what the Egyptians did. They had everything, their whole culture, their whole civilization was based on universal order. So even though they done messed up the calendar with the Gregorian calendar, the Julius Caesar calendar, we still know what time is because the Europeans cannot stop natural phenomena. You cannot stop the rise of Sirius A and Sirius B. Matter of fact, the last time Sirius rise and came close to proximity to Earth was 1970, which corresponds to the beginning of the sun cycle. We're in the sun cycle now. Like I was explaining, we started another period of 6,000 years. Now, at this point right here, this is the end, like I said, of the Devil's Brew in 1914. Now we're going to have to figure out, according biblically, as well as according to the Mayan calendar. The Mayan calendar started around, which corresponds to the Gregorian calendar, around August 12, 31, 4100 BC. And it goes to end December 21st, 2012. Now, and what they said is that it's going to be a cataclysmic event happening, meaning that you're going to have earthquakes, you're going to have tidal waves, you're going to have tsunamis, you're going to have a various worldwide condition. This has happened before. And when you look at the Genesis story, that's just a revision of something that happened prior. Because in order to have creation, you must first have destruction. That's what the number 8 symbolizes, build and destroy, create and rebuild. So now, I'm going to get to the point of what I'm trying to make. According to the teachings of the Most High Prophet Muhammad, the Father of America, he said that you are not left to wander aimlessly. The Holy Quran plainly teaches you and me that Allah will not lead you to wander aimlessly. Then he quotes the Quran and says, does man think that he will be left aimlessly? That's Quran 75, chapter 75, verse 36. He also said, this world's days were up in the year 1914, the devils were grafted. The devil will grant a 7-year grace period on time when it was true. Let me get this back. This world's day were up in 1914. The devil will grant a 7-year grace period on its time, which can collapse any day now. He was telling us. He wrote this back in the 30s. Now I'm going to give you, this is coming. This is a quote from Isaiah. Isaiah the prophet, write this down, Isaiah the scripture, chapter 23, verses 15 and 17. And this is what Isaiah says. And it shall come to pass, in that day, Tyre shall be forgotten, 7 years according to the days of one king. At the end of the 7 years shall Tyre sing as a harlot, and it shall come to pass after the end of 7 years, and that the Lord will visit Tyre, and she shall turn to her heir. Now, a lot of preachers don't explain what that means. Tyre is a symbolic name at this time that we're talking about America. See, the Bible doesn't clearly spell out America. You have to emphasize and understand what it's talking about in the time that we're living in. So they talk about Tyreek, and that's Isaiah the prophet. Now let's see what Jeremiah says, something similar. So we're going on the word of the prophet. Jeremiah chapter 25, verse 11 and 12, it says this. And this whole land shall be a desolation, and atonement, and astonishment. And these nations shall serve the king of Babylon 7 years. And it shall come to pass, when 7 years are accomplished, that I will punish the king of Babylon. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 10. For thus says the Lord, that after 7 years be accomplished at Babylon, I will visit you and perform my good work towards my good word towards and causing you to return to this place. Psalm 90:10 says, the days of our years are three scores. A score is 20 years, so 360, and 10, which is 70 years. Daniel chapter 9, verse 2. I, Daniel, understood by books the number of the years whereof the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah the prophet, that he would accomplish 7 years in the desolation of Jerusalem. The book of Habakkuk. O Lord, revive thy work in thy midst of the years, in the midst of the years, make known in thy wrath, remember mercy. Now this right here, Habakkuk, is talking about this chapter 3, verse 2. It's talking about the grace period. Now if you notice, the prophet's talking about 7 years, 7 years, 7 years. Now, if 1914, it could not be called starting from 1914, because that's not 70 years. Because if you look at 7 years to 1914, you would not get this day and time. It would have been over. I mean, America should have been destroyed. So we have to come to the conclusion, when did the grace period start? Okay, we know that the devil rules us up in 1914. So when did the grace period start? We have to come to that understanding. And I'm going to get to that in a minute. The book of Zechariah, chapter 1, verse 12. O Lord of hosts, how long will thou not have mercy on Jerusalem and on the cities of Judah, against which thou hast had indignation of these three scores and 7 years? Again, it's mentioned. What year did the Federal Reserve take full control of the United States currency? Anybody know?
1913?
That's when it was created.
1931.
Close. 1934, because in 1933. 1933, the United States declared bankruptcy. The United States has been bankrupt since 1933. So how did they get their money? Just how like when you broke. When you don't have the money, what do? You borrow. You borrow Peter to pay Paul. This is what they have been doing over nearly the last 100 years. They have been borrowing to pay their bills. And I just read in the article that China and Russia are coming up with deals to get rid of the dollar so they can trade their own currency. And when that happens, that creates higher inflation. But anyway, 1933 is when the government of the United States declared bankruptcy. That's when President FDR was declaring that you had to turn in all your gold or you'll be held 15 years in prison for a $100,000 fine. The United States has been broke since that point. They have been operating on what's called emergency power. They've been basically fronting. The only thing the United States has been spending the most of their money on is military. They have been able to maintain a strong military presence in the world because they have over 130 bases worldwide. But when you come understand this conspiracy, understand that it's only a group of people who are international bankers who control the economy of the world, you understand the United States is just a pawn in the game. So 1934 is when the year that the Federal Reserve took full control of the United States currency. So from 1934 to now, add 70, what year did you get?
2004.
Now you gotta remember, okay? Now, you gotta ask the question. In 2004, why is America still here? Why it's not been a universal change? If the devil's rule is up, why are they still ruling? You gotta ask yourself that question. I'm gonna continue with that. Okay, I said Habakkuk, the book of Habakkuk talks about, O Lord, Revive thy works in the midst of the years, in the midst of the 7 years, and make known thy wrath and thy mercy. Okay? Now, moving on. The Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad said it, page 19, Fall of America, said, study your Bible, it is there. The end is predicted and hinted at in many places. Now, the book of Ezekiel, chapter 43, verse 10. Thou son of man, show the house to the house of Israel, that they may be ashamed of their iniquities, and let them measure the pattern. Now, I explain to you what Israel means. Israel is not how you think about some Israeli Jews and stuff. It's not talking about it. Is a derivative from Isis, Ra-El. Those Egyptian deities talking about you. You are the original children of Israel. Black people in America and worldwide are the original children of Israel. So it says in this, let them be ashamed of their iniquity. And what that means is, black people should be ashamed that you, what you have allowed the white man have turned you into. He has turned you into homosexual. He has turned you into thieves. He has turned you into criminal. He has criminalized you. Professor Amos Wilson said, you live in a criminogenic society, and a criminogenic means that this is a society that makes you a criminal. In other words, he also put it like this. In order to be dumb, you have to be educated to get dumb. You go to school to be made dumb. When you go to the penal system, you go to the penal system to be criminalized. When you go to the hospital, you be going to make sure everything has its opposite function in this society, because you're dealing with an enemy. You're dealing with a universal enemy, somebody who has raped and pillaged the whole planet ever since they've been here on the planet. But the reason they have been here because their heaven is your head. You have to understand there's no hell under the ground. You got to understand that's a metaphor. Hell is what you make it. So now today, if you live in and you broke as hell, that is hell. If you don't have nothing to eat, you hungry as hell, that is hell. Hell is not a place where you burn it, because then you get into the science of hell must be a physical place, but spirits don't burn. Then fire, you got different types of fire. It's going to be a gas fire, electrical fire, it's going to be a carbon fire. What kind of fire? You got many different types of fire. So if you say hell is going to burn me, that means it's going to be oxygen. So it got to be physical. But most Christians say it's a spiritual place. Again, spirits don't burn, the spirit is energy. So energy cannot burn energy, so therefore it has to be a metaphor talking about the burning. Now the hell that is going to be physical, what could be more hellish for the white man to see? The destruction of his country, the destruction of his nation, the destruction of his work. It talks about that in the Bible and the Quran, that the Quran says this. It says that you cannot hasten your turn, nor can you withhold the turn. What that means is every nation has a turn. Now, black people kill me when I talk about this. They get upset because they love Obama. They feel like it's going to be changed. But you don't understand. You didn't ask what kind of change it's going to be. It's going to be changed for the worse or changed for the better. Because, well, like I have always said, there's no such thing as good white people, there's bad and there's worse white people. When you understand that, you understand that what they have done, they will continue to do, and they always will do, because they have no love for you. You have to understand that. This is why, like I just said, it says in Ezekiel 43, and I'm going to read it again. Thou son of man, you are a son of a human being. Show the house of Israel, that they may be ashamed of their iniquities, and let them measure the pattern. What that means is, measure the pattern, what that means in the Bible, that means you have to measure the pattern. Meaning, if you know the time, you know the agenda, if you know the agenda, you know the time. You have to look at the signs. The signs are, look at the weather condition today. This is December, no snow. You look at the tornadoes worldwide. Those who came to my style in the Morse Command, I showed you around the world things. You got animals dying. You got scientists that say today 98% of life today cannot live under the new sun cycle. They cannot. You can, because you have what's called heat change, what we call melanin. You can survive. You were here before. Now, I'm going to not stop, but what I'm about to do is digress a little bit back to the story of Noah. How long did Noah preach before the flood came?
120 years.
Now, when you get into numerology, 1, 2, and 0, E3. 3 represents understand or overstand. Now, in the Quran, they talk about the same story, but it says it a little different. They talk about Noah had 4 sons. Outside the triplet, he had a son named Riot, who decided that he wanted to play around, and he wanted to drink, and get him married, and party. He didn't have time for that. But when the flood came, he knocked on the door of the ark, because he wanted his father to let him in. His father didn't. He was taken away with the flood. That's how we are today. Now, you have people coming today among you telling you that it's time to get right with your creator, get right with your ancestors. You had Donald Marcus Garvey. You had Noble Drew Ali. You had the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad for over 40 years telling you. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of people say, It's not fair that we be destroyed with these people. Yes, it would be fair. You just not listening. You're not listening to me, and I'm not nothing special. But what I say today, you will meet in weeks and months to come. Reason being, because it's time for it. That's why it's for up to you to measure the pattern. You should be taking a look at the weather. You should be looking at the stars, looking at the patterns of things in the universe. That's how you know what's going on today. I hear people, after I've been teaching for almost 20 years, I hear people still talking about what they're going to do next summer. It's not going to be how you think it's going to be. I can get into more of the part level, but right now you can't bear that now. So now we're going to get with the meat and potatoes of it. We're going to deal with the physicality of it. Okay? Now, Matthew chapter 9 in the New Testament, verse 14 and 15. Then came to him the disciples of John, saying, why do we and the Pharisees fast oft, but the disciples fast not? This is a question they came asking Jesus. Can the children of the bride chamber mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? But the day will come when the bridegroom shall be taken from them, and they shall be, and then they shall fast. And what that represents is that now we have teachers. I'm talking about real sincere teachers. All our sincere teachers are basically dead or locked up. Now we got these charlatans out there. I'm not gonna name them because I'm not gonna saw nobody's character, but it's more important than just to criticize somebody today. Because now today we have to really look at ourselves. Because when you look at symbology in astronomy, you look at the sun being symbolic of the God field, where we had sunlight, we had the God that dwelled among us. He just talked about that in history. Then you had the moonlight, which is the prophet, reflecting the light of God. Now, today, you must have the starlight. Now, you know what star is? Star is the sun, sun is the star. So that solar plex, that solar energy, that spiritual energy must dwell in you. Now, the teaching time is over. Teaching is over. I'm not here, this brother's here, we're here, we're reminders to you. But the teaching is over. What's done is done. As the Honorable Elijah Muhammad said, the die is set. You cannot escape. America should not escape. America has been preserved for this time here right now. America is the strongest nation militarily. Yes, she is. But America is very weak economically. Other nations know that. But at the same time, America will be destroyed by the ancestors. This was the whole thing. Why do you think they make a movie? They made movies about Deep Impact. They had a black president. They made about four movies in the 90s showing you that the end of the world, a black man's coming, and he was the president. And it was all, they made a show, 24, about that. They were telling you, see, the devil has to tell you the truth, but it's not going to be 100% true. You have to figure it out. That's why it says, let them measure the pattern. That's why it says that in Scripture. Let them measure the pattern. You, the children of Israel, you must measure the pattern. Okay? 1934 is, like I said, when they took full control of the year. Now, Jesus, when he's confronted, he gives you the key. Now, we up to 2004. Don't forget that date, 2004. Jesus had 7 years, okay? But before, like I said, I'll quote this again from the Quran, chapter 7, verse 34. It says, and every nation has a term. So when it comes, when its term comes, they cannot remain behind, the least while, nor can they proceed, meaning that America had a time, this world had a time to exist, and you cannot hasten it, and you cannot delay it. Now, a lot of us, we wanted this to end. Some of us did. Those who really know what's going on, you want this crap to end. Now, those who don't know, they don't want it to end because you feel like you need the white man. You have to be with the white man. You're just being legal. But the white man has came here to serve his divine purpose, and he has served it. You're not serving your divine purpose. You're not resurrecting. The whole resurrected story is about resurrecting your conscience, becoming God-like. Because in order to be God, it means that you have to be in control. So the white man is God in a sense. That's why it says in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4, it said that Satan is the ruler of this world. He has been the ruler of this world. If you understand, you'll see that when he had the war in heaven, it's spoken in Revelation in the book of Jude, it talks about Satan was cast to the earth. So the earth was the devil's playing ground. The best trick that he made you think is that he was underground in pantyhose with a pitchfork. That's not reality. The devil is a human being. That's why when you go to the book of Isaiah, chapter 14, chapter 14, verse 12 through 16, it talks about, is this the man that shaketh the nation and the seed of the whole world? He used Satan in the term.